Hello and greetings from Iceland, but this is just a short update covering the earthquakes since January 1st. Even though things may seem calm for some, things are more or less as I predicted when it comes to the Reykjanes Peninsula. But I will also talk about other regions in a moment, but I've had a feeling that the next chapter will start within 2 months, and I'm sticking to that. But this time-lapse is of course not very scientific presentation, but as always, it's meant to show you the big picture. A picture that is telling us now that there is still plenty of unrest, but like I mentioned in a recent video, it seems as a magma intrusion that we expected to come up in Geldingadalir around Christmas is still moving south. And that's the interesting part today. This last frame in the time-lapse shows you all the earthquakes, and let's zoom into Geldingadalir and the magma intrusion highway all the way from Mount Keilir to Geldingadalir. But the action is here now, continuing to move south. So I'm going to show you drone footage from that place, shot from this location. And the earthquakes are now just by this old volcano. So one has to ask, is the magma intrusion still moving? But note that the second magma intrusion from December was indeed way smaller than the one that caused the Geldingadalir eruption, and those earthquakes might just be due to tension or something of that kind. But it is however a bit scary though, since we know what happens if the magma comes up on the seafloor, or a highly explosive eruption just by the fishery town Grindavik and its harbor. And seen from Grindavik, the earthquakes are under this old crater just by the town, so we really can't say that this is an unusual place for volcanic eruption. And this is the place that I suggest that you be aware of in the coming weeks, because we know that the events on the peninsula have just only started, and it's just a matter of time when things start shaking seriously again. And as for other earthquake locations, it's more or less the same story. They are around Mount Thorbjörn in the town, near Lake Klevarvatn, and on the westernmost part of the peninsula. And the only thing I can read from that now is that there is still unusual tension all over the peninsula. And when I checked the earthquakes this morning, I noticed this very interesting lineup from the plate boundaries heading into the city. Earthquakes are not unusual, but this lineup is highly unusual. But it doesn't have to mean anything serious though, just one of the tricks that nature is throwing at us these days. So let's move up to Langjokull Glacier, and I'm showing you the 40-day time-lapse again. An expert said the other day that this might have to do with the geothermal activity under there, but this is a hot region that powers many greenhouses, and the earthquakes continue, but they are spreading out a bit. And a magnitude 6.2 earthquake around there in 1974, which followed seismic unrest that had lasted for 7 months prior to the big one, is telling us that this might just be the beginning of something even worse. But in fact, we just can't tell. We just don't know all that much about this region, but I'm sure our experts are trying to read something from the data that they are getting there now for the first time since modern seismometers came into being. So this is an ongoing story, but let's move to old Katla volcano. But I made a quick update the other day when we got the largest earthquakes there since 2017, but it turned out that she just got the hiccups. And I can add to that story that this is how the town by the volcano looked after the storm the other day. The TV news reported that the town was full of sand, looking like the movie set they made for the Netflix TV series about the volcano. But the town by Katla is just by the coast, and this is what a big storm can do there. But then today, we got other news that the town peoples had contacted the media and said, "You idiots, this is just a thin layer of sand on the snow, so please don't make our town look like a disaster movie." So it's insulted villagers that are the hottest things around there now, and old Katla continues to play games with us. And finally, I just got the replacement drone yesterday, so I'm happy as a horse can be after some treats. I do already have a commercial task waiting for me in East Iceland and I have another job waiting for me close by the Langjokull Glacier unrest. But the weather here in Iceland has been awful lately, so my plans are a bit floating at the moment. But I do have a rather long video about the capital of the north coming up, but it's all depending on weather now, how my work will move on. So there might be a few days until my next upload, if I get the chance to go out photoshooting. And I do admit that I will for sure be way more careful now when it comes to flying the drone in icy conditions. But then, sometimes we just have to go after a light. So, I look forward to be on the road again with all the gear I need to capture Iceland for you. This extremely good group of people who have been so very kind to me in the comment section. And this adventure with my channel is just starting. So until my next upload, I'm sending you best regards from the snowy volcano island, Iceland.